So we're here at Japan's first Comic Con, Tokyo Comic Con. Now you guys might know some of the more known Comic Cons, such as New York Comic Con or San Diego Comic Con, so we can't expect Tokyo Comic Con to be as big as them, of course not. But we're gonna see how Japan fares, because I think they can hold up their own. Follow me. Tokyo Comic Con celebrated all things in pop culture and in nerdism. Throughout the weekend, tens of thousands of people flooded the Makuhari Messe to celebrate their favorite interests. Among these interests include video games and movies such as Resident Evil, Japanese movies such as the hit zombie flick I Am a Hero, anime, and 80s TV shows and movies such as Back to the Future and Knight Rider. First, let's talk about Biohazard, or more commonly known in the West as Resident Evil. Capcom really made their presence felt at Tokyo Comic Con. With the upcoming movie, Resident Evil The Final Chapter, as well as the video game Resident Evil 7 coming out in January 2017, many people flocked to the Resident Evil section. One of their most popular booths was the shooting range, which had a lot of people lined up. There were also a lot of animated figures that you could buy here. Among them were Batman figurines, which were really popular among the crowd here. Some of these models must be really expensive, like the Batman here, or this Harley Quinn. Let's see how much this costs. This is just over $1,100. You can also find and buy Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle figurines, as well as DC comic figurines. One of the biggest draws to any Comic Con must be the cosplayers. These cosplayers dress up in your favorite TV shows, anime, movies, and video games. Let's check out these cosplayers. After a while, even I couldn't hold back, so I had to get some pictures with these cosplayers. After all that cosplaying, it's time to go eat. Pizza here is $10. Pretty pricey. Alright, time to get back to the cosplaying. Tokyo Comic Con also had a cosplay competition. So in this scene, several Stan Lee cosplayers reenact several of his cameos during various movies. Here, several Umbrella soldiers take on Dr. William Birkin in his mutated state. In fact, her cosplay was so good, they ended up taking first place. And this person is cosplayed as Ega Dorobo. And if you guys don't know who Ega Dorobo is, it's basically the mascot you show up when watching a Japanese movie in a movie theater. Ega Dorobo's motto is, you better not illegally record during movies. Just check out all those dance moves this guy has. Wow! And here are the rest of the cosplayers during the competition. Check it out. In the end, Tokyo's first Comic Con was a smashing success. With the blend of anime, movies, TV shows, and video games, it was a blast to come here. Tokyo Comic Con also showed just how big Western pop culture is here, as well as cosplaying. If you're ever in Asia and get a chance to visit Tokyo Comic Con, please do so. You'll have a lot of fun. So I hope you guys enjoyed our coverage of Tokyo Comic Con, and I know you guys love all things geekery and all things comic related, but as you guys know, our focus is on Asian films, so if you guys want to learn more about Asian films, please hit the subscribe button below, and if you guys want to learn more about Asian movie suggestions, please download our free ebook, The 108 Asian Movies to Watch. So until next time, we'll see you in the next video. Take it easy, guys.